Okay, guys, we all know what the most asked question is at the Alley Cantina. Are you serving food? Yes, we are. Well, here's the second most asked question. Is there any entertainment there tonight? And I say yes. At the Alley Cantina, we have entertainment every night. That's right, 7 nights a week, entertainment at the Alley Cantina, the place for live entertainment. That's the Alley Cantina, entertainment every night. Got it?
And I'm honored to be here and to help celebrate once again the life of Buzz. In case you don't know what's going on, you may have noticed that we left a little laundry out. Oops. This is Buzz's collection. Isn't it amazing? In so many different ways. I think it was a brilliant idea by our dear Ruth to raise some money for Stray Arts Animal Shelter. And as such, in case you didn't know, every one of these shirts is for sale today, and all the money goes to Stray Arts Animal Shelter. I don't know if you've heard, but they have music from time to time here at the Alley Cantina. In fact, I think I had a commercial on the radio the other day that said every day of the week. As such, because these musicians have loved Buzz for so many years, a whole collection of them are in one place right here tonight, and they're gonna entertain us. And yes, they serve food here. Thanks to all these wonderful musicians who have brought their talents to this stage so many times down through the years. And tonight, one more time for Buzz Waterhouse. Yes.
I would just like to thank Buzz Waterhouse for, I think, basically single-handedly creating the music scene in Taos. Before Buzz and the Alley came along, there was like a gig here and a gig there, you know. And Buzz started having music every night of the week. And then every other club in town had to have music because nobody wanted to go anywhere else. So all of a sudden, every club in town was having live music. And I think it's all because of Buzz Waterhouse. So I just wanted to throw that out.
Okay, folks, I know you've been waiting breathlessly for this. I now have a third most frequently asked question at the Alley Cantina. And the envelope, please. The question is, will you be open? The answer, yes! We're always open, 365 days a year, serving food with entertainment every day. The Alley Cantina is open. Open early, open late. The Alley Cantina, open, open, open.
I think as we go through tonight, it's important to remember that all of us are joined here in the Alley Cantina, in the Alley Cantina family, in the Waterhouse family, joined together by Buzz and the Waterhouses, and that for better or worse, we always will be.
Yes.
Mark Twain was once asked, "What would men be without women?" And he replied, "Scarce, sir. Mightily scarce." I remember when I first started working at the Alley Cantina, Pearl Mabry came up to me and she said, "I know what you think you're doing, but it's not going to work." She could have been talking about any number of things, but she was talking to my really, really stupid idea that I could be Buzz's boy and I could do everything Buzz wanted. And I wouldn't have to worry about anything else. Like maybe what Ruth might want. And sure enough, like 2 weeks later, Ruth and I were having like, you know, the third in our hundreds of battles about stupid stuff. And Buzz comes up to me and he goes, "What are you doing?" He goes, "Ruth is my wife and my partner, and I love her very much. Is that okay with you?" And I said, "Yes, Buzz." And that day I was able to keep my job for one thing, and I was introduced to a very, very important concept, and one that I've tried to emulate with varying success over the years. But Ruth, he just loved you so much. And I learned a lot about what a strong couple looks like, because there is no daylight between the two.
Okay, this is backed by special request. Oh, baby, meet me at the alley. Oh, yeah. Hurry on down. Come on now, baby, meet me at the alley. The hippest place in town. Now you take Paseo Pueblo Norte, Paseo Pueblo Sur, Kit Carson Road, but I know the alley is the best place to go to with your toad. Why toad? Rhymes with road. And if I had a toad, I would absolutely bring it to the Alley Cantina.
Very nice. A few weeks later, one of our waitresses, Miss Aline Day, who I hope is with us somehow in spirit right now tonight, was just putting Buzz through the ringer. I was like, "Well, my landlord this, and my boyfriend that, and my other friend, and this guy won't cover my shift, and this girl is doing this, and she's not doing her side work." And she finally stormed off, and Buzz was just like, just shaking. And, you know, being the smart guy that I am, I said, "Well, you know, Buzz, they say that after having children, having employees is the greatest responsibility that a man can have." And he said, "Yes, I know that, Mark. But my children are all grown and taking care of their own problems, and my employees can't seem to work that out." And that was when I was introduced to the concept of Chani, who I would get to know over the years, and who is just so lovely, and is the apple of her father's eye. And I know that when Elvin came along, and Orla, he was very rich in apples. He loved those kids just so much, and loved you, Chani, so much.
These amazing musicians, so this is really special for me.
Thank you, Chani.
Thank you very much.
Tarnished angel, I love you just as you are. Our worlds are strange and different, but love, they say, is blind. I'll try to live in your world, and you won't live in mine.
First one's name, sweet Anne Marie, she's my heart's delight. Second one is prison baby, sheriff's on my trail. And if he catches up with me, I'll spend my life in jail. I got a wife in Chino, one in Cherokee. First one said she got my child, but it don't look like me.
I want to talk about the new homemade mud pie at the Alley Cantina. It's really good, but it's not made out of mud. Our building, which is really old, is made out of mud. But the mud pie, which is new, is made from cookie crumbs, coffee ice cream, chocolate, Kahlua, and amaretto. Yum! But not mud. So just to review, the Alley Cantina mud pie, new, really good, not made of mud. The Alley Cantina building, old, great, made of mud. Here's mud in your pie.
Some men found a rainbow's eye of gold. Some men search for silver, soft for gold. I have found my treasure in your soul. Honey, All I ever need is you.
And the truth of the matter is I do not have any words of wisdom for any of you. What I have for you all, and so many other people that are not here tonight, people who have, you know, called, emailed, sent prayers, sent good wishes from different parts of the country, actually, people who used to work for Buzz, people who appreciated Buzz, like I do. So I've thought about writing a speech, but it didn't seem possible to write a speech about this feeling that I'm looking at you like, holy shit, you know? There's so many people who cared about him, who care about us, care about the shelter. Our whole life with Roy Honda, with the Alley Cantina, before it was the Taos Inn. You get these families developing. They're like societies. They're like fraternities or sororities. And we had that at the Alley Cantina for so many years, and now it's like quadrupled or more than that. It's been 20 years. We sold it 2 years ago. One of my regrets is that Buzz only got to retire for 2 years. I'm really sad about that. But these societies in these small towns are so potent. This is community. This is family. We all know each other. We all care about each other. And we all love each other. We show up when people need each other. Like now, this is the best time I've had since June 18th. By far, I feel so supported. If I didn't feel so supported by all of you,
thank you.
You know, I would have fallen to the ground also.
June 18th, 2015. There's no getting around that. That's why we're all here today. And it was a truly, truly horrible, horrible day. And since that day, we have all been so wrapped up and so busy. It's the high time in the Taos with the tourist season. So many arrangements and so many thoughts and deeds that went into organizing this affair. Thank you, Jessica. I found myself in Albuquerque earlier this week, waiting for my mom's flight to come in. Hi, Mom. And having dinner and drinks with Tony Fernandez down in Albuquerque. And we started talking about Buzz and just how much he meant to us. And I found myself just sobbing in the middle of a Twin Peaks, which is like some kind of Hooters knockoff. And I realized that it was the first time that I had had the space, the time, the luxury, the perspective to cry for my friend and to mourn his passing in a full-blooded and full-throated way.
Everybody here, of course, you know, is we've been supporting each other for 20 years. All the employees here, all the owners here, we changed ownership 2 years ago. You know, I'm now the landlady, or whatever.
Yeah, landlady! Our landlady! We love our landlady!
Where's the rent? All these bars and restaurants in town and different businesses, they become like societies. They become like clubs. I'm looking around, people wearing business shirts, it's like, oh.
Ruth, I want that shirt! Ruth, can I have that shirt?
It's certainly true tonight. I see people walking around with these shirts that I recognize. They're not my husband. They're my friends. They're my support system. They're all these people that I've known for years and years and years, and sometimes fewer years and sometimes more years. So it's unbelievable that you're all here. For me, this is over the top from what I expected. I expected a really nice time, but without this support, this community, and now I have my Stray Hearts community, I have my Alley Cantina community, I have my neighborhood community, I would have hit the ground also, I'm sorry to say that, but it's unbelievable what you guys have all done for us.
I love him. Here's the Buzz! Salud!
There are very few people in any town, particularly this town, who can qualify as an official legend. And I think we can go ahead and bestow that upon Buzz. No doubt about it, he was a legend.
And celebrate the man. Celebrate his life, celebrate his words, which were so clever, celebrate his deeds. And celebrate this excellent fellowship, all these friends that are here today. My mother likes to tell people that she does not want any of the credit for my good traits because she does not want any of the blame for my bad ones. And that is a wise woman. She can run the numbers. She knows. And I know that Buzz would just so heartily and profoundly second that notion when it came to me in particular. But the fact remains that here I stand, and it's all because of Buzz and because of Ruth. Pulled into Taos in 2001 on a particularly crappy February day, and I got out and I was like, really? and checked into the hotel, put my dog Dash up, and I said, where can I go get a drink? They said, oh, you need to go to the Alley Cantina. And it was a Wednesday night, and the rest is sort of history. But I sat down, and I was greeted by the bartender, sort of. And he said, well, what do you have? And there was a napkin there, and I said, I'd like a margarita. And before I finished the word margarita, there's a margarita in front of me. Buzz would explain to me later that any monkey in a tuxedo can do fine bartending, but it takes a pretty special person to be able to do speed bartending. And that's what we're all about at the Alley Cantina. You know, you might not always like the way it goes here, but you will not be thirsty. So I started asking Buzz a bunch of questions. I asked him for a menu. Bah, there's a menu right there before I could even finish. And I look and I say, chips and salsa, $3.50. With guacamole, $6.50. So that must be some guacamole. And he said, hey, avocados are really expensive. I was like, all right, well, I'm going to have one of these expensive avocados. So I started asking Buzz a bunch of questions about Taos, where I should walk my dog, where I should try to find a place, when was he going to be hiring, you know, all the... And he just quickly had enough of that. He's like, you see that lady over in the corner? Why don't you go talk to her? And I went over and introduced myself, and she said, my name's Ruth, and we're going to go for a dog walk on Friday, and you should bring your dog and meet us. And I said, well, how long have you been coming here, Ruth? And she said, oh, that's my husband is the bartender. I said, that's so cute. You come in to watch your husband bartend? That's sweet. You know, later, they own the place, Mark. Who knew? Not me. So I waited and I waited, and I did a little bit of, there's not really a better word for it, stalking. I rented a place, I called Buzz. He's like, who? I'm like, my name's Mark. I was in like Wednesday that, you know, 3 weeks ago. He's like, all right. I'm like, I rented a place, I'm here, I'm good. He's like, okay. I'm like, well, I got a phone, here's my number. And just continued to come in and talk to him and badger him. And one night the phone call came. Do you still want to work at the Alley Cantina? Yes, I do. He said, well, we need a bouncer. Show up 8:00 on Thursday night. Dana will train you. I said, excuse me, you're going to have a chick train me how to bounce? And he said, Dana is a man. And then he hung up on me. So it's 14 years and change later, and the Ivy League bouncing crew was together for most of it. So a month after I started, this lady comes up and she goes, oh, it's the Ivy League bouncing crew. Buzz gets her money. He always got the money. And he goes, what did she mean by that? And I said, well, you went to Dartmouth, did you not? And she said, and he said, yeah. I said, well, I went to Harvard. He goes, well, how did I not know that? I said, I don't know, Buzz. We got to know each other very well over the next 14 years or so through dead dogs, dead shifts, dead relationships, fist fights, cat fights, staff fights. And he, I don't know what to say, he had a profound effect on me and the man that I am today, but only the good parts. And he, gave me a job, taught me a trade, gave me a living, made me part of the family, and made it turn out so that I have, you know, some of the finest friends and coworkers that a man could ever ask for. He taught me to try to be righteous without being self-righteous, taught me to try to be confident without being self-confident, maybe conscious without being self-conscious, and maybe absorbed without being self-absorbed. Well, if I've done as a meandering a job as I fear I might have, then you guys are probably out here wondering why J.R.R. Tolkien, why Mark Twain, why all these instruments and musicians, and the easiest answer is because Buzz loved those two guys. And I don't really know what it was. I mean, obviously a sense of humor, because Buzz had a tremendous sense of humor. Maybe a sense of optimism and a sense of wonderment, a sense of what's possible, particularly on the Tolkien side. Mark Twain wrote, "What a wee little part of a person's life are his acts and his words. His real life is led in his head and is known to none but himself." And then, who knows, maybe with the same pen, or maybe he wrote it before, I'm not really sure. He wrote that when we think of friends and call their faces out of the shadows and their voices out of the echoes that faint along the corridors of memory, and do it without knowing why, save that we love to do it, we content ourselves that friendship is a reality and not a fancy, that it is builded upon a rock and not upon the sands that dissolve away with the ebbing tides and carry their monuments with them. So I guess if we're here for one reason tonight, it's to try to evoke Buzz's memory, evoke Buzz's giant personality, show love to his family, and to celebrate the man.
So the shrimp comes into a bar, goes over to the bar stool, tries to flip himself up onto it. The bartender sees him, comes running over, says, Hey, you there, aren't you a shrimp? Why, yes, I am, says the shrimp. Well, you got to get out of here. We don't serve shrimp here, says the bartender. You don't serve shrimp? The shrimp asks. No, says the bartender. Well, says the shrimp, I guess I'll just go over to the Alley Cantina. The Alley Cantina, that's the place for shrimp.
Well, when I told these guys I wanted to say a few words for my friend Buzz, I didn't realize I had to follow Mark Geary. So. That's right. This is a Buzz Waterhouse original, by the way, and I think it's the best one on the rack here, but it's not for sale. I got it. About close to 20 years ago now, Buzz hired me, and as he said, I was the only guy he ever hired without ever interviewing first. He just had a feeling about me, so he brought me on board. He started off as my boss and became one of my closest friends. I had the pleasure of the last close to 15 years of golfing with Buzz every Tuesday for as long as we can remember. And those were some of the highlights of my summer every year. We're getting to spend this time one-on-one with Buzz outside of work and the craziness here. And pretty much every round he'd say, okay, I gotta talk shop. But this is all I'm gonna say, one thing. Now let's play golf and have some fun. I learned a lot from Buzz on the golf course as well as here. I learned the art of really creative cussing. He could string words together I didn't know went together at all. And every time he'd look at me and smile afterwards and say, sorry. See, that's okay, Buzz. He also taught me not to blame myself for a lot of problems. When we were on the golf course, he blamed the wind, the grass, the superintendent, whatever it was.
Go
And I looked at him and smiled one time if he was saying that effing pomegranate grass on the green, you know, see how it turned like ball there? And I looked and kind of gave him a grin, and he looks at me and smiles. He says, if I blamed every bad shot I made on myself, I'd have a horrible time. So I got to blame something for this. He also passed along so many bits of wisdom to me over the year. I don't know if I've put any of them into use, but he was not only one of my best friends, but like a real father figure to me, and taught me more than...
Yay!
All I know is I loved Buzz Waterhouse very dearly, and I still love his wife, Ruth. And I miss him every day. He created something amazing here, and I'm fortunate enough to be the one that got to, along with my wife and Jim Hip, to step in his place here and take this over, and I feel so lucky for that. I looked at Buzz one day, and we were just talking about the current staff at the time, and I said, you realize that there are 7 members of your staff right now who have been able to buy a home while working for you here. And he said, I didn't, never really thought about that, and I think it was a big subject of pride for him. And I've worked for Buzz and Ruth nearly my entire adult life, and this has been the most amazing thing that I could ever have asked for. I'm just glad everybody's here to celebrate Buzz. He's worth celebrating. He had the best sense of humor of any guy I've ever known.
And I think we can all agree that this place is in no better hands than AA, Jessica, and Jim. And on the golf thing, AA was kind enough to not mention, but I've played with Buzz before too. Somehow, just as you were leaning over, concentrate on that putt, there'd be a little rattling of keys. There'd be some kind of club being pulled out of the bag. Some kind of noise just at that right point. That's how Buzz played golf.
You know, we've been serving coconut shrimp at the Alley Cantina for some time now, and people just love it. Unfortunately, that's made the chicken fingers really jealous. They've been acting up in the kitchen, pouting, and making a fuss. How come the shrimp get coconut and not us? So, we proudly present Coconut Chicken Fingers. Our fabulous chicken fingers, coated in shredded coconut and panko breadcrumbs, then fried to golden perfection. Coconut Chicken Fingers at the Alley Cantina. Take that, shrimp!
Sometimes when I'm down and all alone, just like a child without a home, your love just keeps me hanging on. Honey, all I ever need is you.
You're my first love, you're my last. You're my future, you're my past. Loving you is all I ask. Honey, all I ever need is you.
Just come, let it go. And we watch the mountains snow. Sure as summer follows spring, all the things you do give me a reason to build my world around.
What about the neighbors? What are they gonna say? Little sisters at the Alley Cantina getting carried away. Hey, hey. Little sister.
What it is,
what it is, what it is?
When it's alone,
town ever. But my best memory was when he took me up. He took me up in his ultralight for my birthday. And it was amazing. He flew me over my house. He flew me over the golf course. He flew me over his house. You know, what a marvelous, sweet man. I am so grateful to have known him. And I'm so grateful that he did that for me. It's my best memory in this town ever.
Hi. Buzz took me for a ride in his ultralight also about 11 years ago. The same, flying over the golf course, their house. I think we went over my house. But shortly after that, he took my mother up in his plane on her 85th birthday. She made the front page of the Taos News the next day. It was really fun.
And now, the news. A miracle has been reported in the northern New Mexico town of Taos. Pilgrims are flocking to the Alley Cantina to see for themselves that the rumors are true. The Alley Cantina is now non-smoking. That's right, you heard that correctly, and you heard it here first. No smoking at the Alley Cantina. And here's another flash. The government of France has announced that it has surrendered to the Alley Cantina, and the entire country will now be no smoking.
We figured what better way than to honor Buzz than to really go way back in our roots and sort of unplug everything and deconstruct everything and make it really simple. But before we start, so we were playing here at the Alley Cantina when the no smoking indoors at bars rule was enacted. And Buzz, I believe at the time being a fellow smoker, basically let me know that the cigarette smoking was actually part of the show. It was part of the act, and it could technically not be construed as smoking in a bar if it's a prop. So in honor of Buzz, I'm gonna light this up. Please do not do as I do. Sometimes I want you to do as I say. But every time I'm in a bar and I see somebody smoking, it makes me think of Buzz. So I'm gonna light this up. Thank you for letting me smoke in the Alley Cantina, Buzz, when smoking in the Alley Cantina was illegal for everyone else. So I'm just gonna do this one more. That is delicious.
When you crack the sky, scrapers fill the air. Will you keep on building higher till there's no more room up there? Will you make us laugh? Will you make us cry? Will you tell us when to live? Will you tell us when to die? I know we've come a long way. We're changing day to day. But tell me, when did the children play?
Mark Twain wrote one time, "Life is short. Break the rules. Forgive quickly. Kiss slowly. Love truly. Laugh uncontrollably. And never regret anything that makes you smile."
I don't know what it is that makes me love you so. I only know I only wanna let you go. 'Cause you started something, can't you to see. And only when we're in love like this, it matters to be true. I only want to be with you. It doesn't matter where you go or what you do. I want to spend each moment of the day with you. Cause you started something, can't you see? I never knew that I could be in love like this. It's crazy, but it's true. I only want to be with you. You stopped and smiled at me, asked if I cared to dance. I fell into your open arms. I didn't stand a chance. But let me tell you, I just want to be beside you every day. As long as we're together, darling, I don't care. Cause you started something, can't you see? Never knew that I could be in love like this. It's crazy, but it's true. I only want to be with you. It's crazy, but it's true. I only want to be with you.
God bless.
That Tuesday, February 16th, that monkey, the Alley Cantina. Feed the monkey. Funky monkey. Make the monkey fat. Fat monkey. Fat Tuesday. Monkey man. Monkey woman. Monkey feeders. Monkey feeders at the Alley Cantina on Fat Tuesday. That's the Alley Cantina. Monkey feeders. Fat Tuesday, February 16th at 9:30.